Hello students, welcome to the class. This is Praveen and you are watching Praveen Tutorials for Physics. So in this class, just a simple question I will discuss with you, that is based on the relation between radius of curvature and focal length of the mirror. So what is the relation between radius of curvature and focal length of the mirror? Here the relation is R equal to 2f, or simply we can say focal length is half of the radius. That means we can write as f equal to r by 2. So what are the possible questions based on this relation here? So here you may see nearly three types of questions asking based on this relation. So first question is, the radius of curvature of a spherical mirror is 20 centimeters, then what is the focal length? So to find out the focal length of the spherical mirror, here you have to note down what are the values are given here. So first relation is R equal to 2f. So we can convert by transposing f equal to R by 2. So here you need a focal length. So we will use the relation f equal to R by 2. So here note down the given value R equal to 20 centimeters, then f equal to question mark. So we will find out f equal to, so use the relation to find out. Here drop r value in the given relation. So f equal to 20 by 2 we can write. Then cancel it by using 2 table. 2 times 10 equal to 20. So that 10 is the value of focal length. So f equal to 10 centimeters. So it may be asked for 1 mark or half mark in your examination. Then another types of questions are also possible. What we have to do if the question asked as follows here. The question is, here the focal length of the spherical mirror is 10 centimeters. Then what is the radius of curvature? So now you will use the relation R equal to 2f. Then note down the value of f is given 10 centimeters in the problem, then substitute in the relation, that is R equal to 2 into 10. So finally, by taking the product of 2 and 10, you will write is at 20 centimeters. So here the radius of curvature of the given spherical mirror is 20 centimeters. So students, you may ask here, what are the other possibilities to ask the question based on this relation? So definitely we have other possibilities also. So what are the possibilities here? So one of the possibility is by giving the type of a spherical mirror. So here the question is, what is the focal length of the concave mirror if the radius of curvature is given as 20 centimeters? So here you have noticed the difference between the questions here. So in the previous questions, just only he mentioned as a spherical mirror. But in this particular question, the type of mirror is given as a concave. So if any particular type of mirror is mentioned in the given question, just you need to apply the sign convention rules here. So according to sign convention, concave mirror hides its radius of curvature in front of the mirror. So whatever it may be, the quantity or parameter measured in front of the mirror, that is given with the negative sign according to sign convention rules. So we will write R equal to minus 20 centimeters in the given quantities. So substitute that R equal to minus 20 centimeters in the relation F equal to R by 2. So R equal to minus 20 substituted means you will get minus 20 by 2. So here 2, 10 times equal to 20. So by cancelling you will get minus 10 centimeters as the final. So F equal to minus 10. So the relation is used to find out the focal length. The focal length of the concave mirror is 10 centimeters. Here the minus is indicating the mirror type is concave. If you get a plus in the answer, that plus stands for the convex mirror. So just remember the following logic here. For always concave mirror radius of curvature as well as the focal length measured in front of the mirror. So its focal length as well as radius of curvature always negative. For a convex mirror, we will measure the focal length and its radius of curvature behind the mirror. So behind the mirror, any quantity measure, it is given as positive. So always the focal length as well as the radius of curvature of a convex mirror always
positive.
So you may understand this as simple concept. So useful for 1 mark and a half mark. Thank you. And we will meet with the next.